called Faith, Folk and Anarchy.
Thank you. Well, the heart is a mystery. Stumble out of bed each day and struggle to be free. Stood by an ocean raging blue. Big wave cracked the sidewalk and I fell down there with you, fell in with you. Scoured the land and the sunset glow. You think you know, my friend, you just don't know. That's why the heart is a mystery. Break it in two, you will see things you could not see before. Sing with us, everybody. One, two, three, go!
I search for you.
Found and lost you on the way.
I search for you.
Over the hill of a better day.
I search for you.
Every mile I couldn't comprehend.
And I search for you.
And I'll do it again. We should only frame you in a metaphor. Not cast you off in our own image anymore. big questions etched across that great big Salisbury sky. The weight and the reason of everything we'd like to know.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, go!
I search for you.
Found and lost you on the way.
I search for you.
Over the hill of a better day.
I search for you.
Every mile I could comprehend.
I search for you.
And I'll do it again. Saw the blessing, saw the curse. Seen my best and I've seen my worst. Seen a little beauty and I've seen a little hate. Great indifference and a twist of fate. Seen a lot of passion and empathy. The power and the greed of the me. Seen a lot of suffering, seen a lot of good. The big life love of a neighborhood. A needle in the arm and the sadness grow. Holy in the hidden and the outcast soul. Seen a lot of surplus but in the wrong place. In the eyes of the broken I thought I saw your face.
I search for you.
Found and lost you on the way.
I search for you.
That's over the hill of a better day. But I'm standing here in a passion play.
I search for you.
Just give me a sign, I'll be there straight away.
I search for you.
Stood in line till I don't know when.
I search for you.
Every mile I couldn't comprehend.
I search for you.
And I'll do it again. Shrewsbury. See, the heart is a mystery. Don't we stumble out of bed each day and struggle to be free? To stand by the ocean raging blue. And search for you.
Thank you.
When we put this project together 15 years ago, the idea was we just didn't want to take it in turn singing our hits. I haven't had one. Maybe. We thought we would learn one another's songs.
Some of us haven't headlined the Royal Albert Hall eight times.
So this is my choice of Martyn's song. It's called I Will Follow. I've been looking to the time when I first saw you, when life was so sweet, seemed so right. And I know you'll never change. I know you never will. But the winds of life have blown me all around. I will follow. I must go on and on. I will follow.
Wherever you lead me, I will follow on.
And the lives that they lead me are the lives I live. They have their fill. Alone. As a rise.
wherever you lead me, I will follow on.
And the passion in my spirit is the passion of my soul. Keeps me yearning, keeps me running on and on. I will follow.
I must go on and on.
I will follow.
Wherever you lead me, I will follow.
Next, it was my turn to raid the Steve Knightley songbook. And from the original project back in 2002, when we toured together, dusted this one off. It sounds bang up to date. This is the Cold Heart of England. Hard winds are blowing down the high street today. Just look around you. Family firms selling up and moving away. And the names that surround you. And though they're familiar, you don't feel at home. You could be in Kansas. You could be in Rome. They're all closing down in the small country towns, in the cold heart of England. You don't see the stars when the light's overspilled. It's too bright and too strong. From hundreds of homes on the side of the hill, just where did we come from? And now we've been told to build 10,000 more and cover the countryside we came here for. Trees coming down at the edge of the town, the cold heart of England. Well, it's Saturday night with the boys in the square. The cars and the fights, broken glass everywhere. I've no picture postcard to send you from here. It's the cold heart of England. Supermarkets instead of green fields to pay all our wages. We're choking in traffic and tied to the wheel like cattle in cages. If you work within limits, the law will allow your lands under concrete instead of the plow.
swampy, we need you right now. In the cold heart of England, in the cold heart of England.
Thank you, Tom. Years before I met Martyn, we used to have a show tape. This is before Phil and I even started playing with Miranda. We used to have a tape we played before the concerts, you know, just various artists. And this song was on it. I didn't know the writer. And so I heard this every night for year after year, just as we were about to come on stage. And all these years later, it's such a pleasure. This is Martyn's hometown song from Cardiff. This is Cardiff Bay.
I took my son and his tear-stained face out of Sunday school. As the chapel hymn began to fade away, left his mother with the other and we drove across our town, going to the place where the seagulls and the cranes play. On a Sunday over Cardiff Bay, this is one day of our lives. On the Sunday Cardiff Bay, know that I love you. All of my life.
The old man in the side street make you smile. He waved it at both and we both waved by. Way on through Butte Street to the mount of the low tide. They tear the old place down, but some things stay the same.
On a Sunday over Cardiff Bay, this is one day of our lives. On a Sunday over Cardiff Bay, know that I love you. I hope you realize it. Captain Scott on the Terra Nova, setting sail for open sea. It may be one day when you're older, you're gonna come down this way and you might think of me. Sunday over Cardiff Bay, it'll be one day of your life. On that Sunday over Cardiff Bay, know that I loved you.
On a Sunday over Cardiff Bay, this is one day of our lives, yes. On a
the Sunday over Cardiff Bay.
Know that I love you, and I hope that's
thank you, Shrewsbury. Thank you very much.
This is a song about a road protest that happened near Fairmile in Honiton. Digging down, 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 digging down. It's got one of those classic folk choruses. I heard it at Topsham Folk Club, and I still, to my shame, don't know the author of this song, but I collected it on the phone, listened to it on the phone, and Phil and I played this in India exactly 20 years ago. And we sang a song about a road protest, and this very cultivated guy came up and said, "Wonderful song, but why would anybody object to a road being built?" Occurred to me, it's all about context and time and place, but there's nothing like a folk festival audience to sing a chorus, so please help us out. Come listen to me and I'll sing you a song. Though it might offend you, it won't take me long. It's of the boat diggers at Fairmile Camp, deep underground in the cold and the damp. Digging down, 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 digging down. Try that. Digging down, 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 digging down. There's Ian and Animal, Pete and Welsh, John, and Swampy of fame I'll include in my song. There's no finer diggers in Devon, it's true, and the poor under sheriff don't know what to do. Digging down, 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 digging down. So the bailiffs they dug and they shored up with planks, while hundreds of policemen they stood by in ranks. They thought they had reached them but soon felt quite sick when they found a steel door that was 5 inches thick. Digging down, 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 digging down. So here's to the fine moles of old Fairmile cops. They'll be there in spirit until the road stops. Lift up your voices, raise up a glass. They gave the road builders a kick up the ass. Digging down, 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 digging. And again, digging down, 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 digging down.
Well sung.
There are some advantages to getting older. Contrary to what we believed back in... Is anyone here old enough to remember the 60s? Do you remember that book, Don't Trust Anyone Over 30? There's not many of us left. But anyway, one advantage is that you can waste a lot of time as a young person in your teens and early 20s looking for your ideal lover. We all know there is one out there, and we waste an awful lot of time because we know we like somebody who's about that high and that colored eyes, and they'll be like this, but they won't be like that. And we search for this impossible dream that simply doesn't exist. But then, as you get a little older, if you're really lucky, one day you open your eyes and you suddenly realize the person you were looking for has been there all the time. Hey there, lonely with your life on hold, uptight and terrified of getting old, saving your affection for the special one, the ideal lover who will never come. Big Mr. Fantasy, you're fond farewell, your ideal lover, boy, you know him well. Why keep waiting for the eyes of blue when the eyes of love are looking right at you? Won't be the lover that you might expect. Been like a brother since the day you met. He sees your weakness and he knows your faults, but you don't seem to notice him at all. The one you run to when you're all alone, with endless confessions on the telephone. The one that's fun whenever life's a party. The one who hugs you when you're broken hearted. The one
the only one. He's the one. He's the only one.
Well, don't try to tell me it would be a crime to mess up your friendship after all this time. Have you ever listened to a word he said? Forget the friend and see the man instead. He wants your love, and what do you expect? Along with your tenderness and deep respect. His lips are gentle, but his hands are firm. Hold tight now, you got a lot to learn from the one. He's the only one. From the one. He's the only one. And it's you. Yes, it's you, 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 you. About the lies you tell. Bad or angry, you can be yourself. He couldn't care less about the mess you're in. He couldn't care less about your next of kin. He doesn't give a damn about the clothes you wear. Doesn't give a damn about the state of your hair. He doesn't give a damn about the life you led. He doesn't give a damn whoever shared your bed. You're the one. You're the only one. You're the one. You're the only one. And it's you, 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 you. The one he wants is you, 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 you. Yes, it's you.
Mr. Tom Robinson. Thank you.
You okay?
Yeah.
Excellent.
No, it's not Shrewsbury. It's
Shrewsbury. I know.
She just said Shrewsbury.
No one noticed until you just said that, though. I suppose for some reason I represent faith up here. I used to. I don't know if I do anymore.
Oh, tell me about it. I'm enjoying my slippers and my freedom pass.
Yeah, so.
Anarchy?
Anarchy.
What anarchy? Steve likes a nice glass of Beaujolais.
Yeah. I was folk, but now I'm class A drugs. You're anarchy now. You're sort of order and discipline. And Martyn, you're, well, you're Welsh.
So, on the whole, Martyn, is this a good time for God?
I think so. And this goes out. Well, no, it's not. It never has been. And this goes out to everyone who sort of says, you know, they stand on stage, they say, God gave me this song, and then you hear the song, you know why God wanted to get rid of it. So.
Not a good time for God, not a good time. Atheists deplore him, hedonists ignore him, men with bombs adore him. Agnostic never heed, and think tanks never heed orthodoxy creeds him. It's not a good time for God, not a good time. Singing alle, 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 alle. Singing alle, 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 alle. got a good time for God. And a good time. The right wing have defaced, the left wing have displaced. Bigotry's disgraced him. Apocalyptics claim, prosperous preachers claim, perverted clerics shame him. It's not a good time for God. Not a good time. Not a good time. Fashion sanitized, styles accessorized, robes and rings disguise him, and the mysticism hide, sophisticates deride, evolution chides him. All those empty churches lost him, close friends double cross him, the crucifixion cost him. Never been a good time for God. It's just not a good time. Hey!
Singing alle, 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 singing alle, 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 alle,
alle. Hey.
When we did our first tour 15 years ago, we did cross over to Flanders for a festival, and we sang a song, and in the middle of the song, Tom launched into a fluent Dutch speech, which amazed Martyn and I, and then we went to a restaurant in the French part of Belgium, and he started speaking fluently in French to the waiter. I said, what else? He said, oh, well, German, obviously. Touch of Italian. And then Japanese guy walked by. Someone, I thought I heard him. Japanese, he said, oh, well, just a touch. A man of many parts, many talents. And this song for me is located in that part of the world. It's Flanders is the most wonderful area. The beer and the chocolate and the meat and the hospitality. And I've always loved the writing of Jacques Brel. And this song very much reminds me of a Jacques Brel song. It's one of Tom's, set in Antwerp. It's called You Tattooed Me.
Tattooed me.
Shacked up in basements, behind broken doors, bed bugs in the blanket, broken glass on the floor. We were penniless and hungry with our quarrels and fights. I coughed blood through that winter, but I felt so alive. And then on one fateful day, you signed your life away. I was too weak for alarm. I was drunk in my sleep when you left for the fleet. Oh, you tattooed your name on my arm. You tattooed me. In Geneva, the world crawled away from the edge of a blue, and we all breathed again. I heard you deserted, but no letters came. My life was in pieces, but I started again. And when I was on the mend, I drifted down to Zaventem, worked there, unloaded the planes. I made my way on a thousand a day, but I never saw you again. Although you tattooed me,
tattooed.
Thank you very much.
I first met Martyn Joseph on a TV show in Belfast in 1992. I was promoting some record which I've forgotten since, but I do remember the record that Martyn Joseph was promoting because we're about to sing it. It was a wonderful song called Please Sir. Who else was on the show that day, Martin?
Ian St. John, the footballer, and Dana.
Rock and roll, then.
Yeah. Oh. The Kelly Show.
Happy days.
Happy days, indeed. And I couldn't believe it. I thought, there's Tom Robinson. That's the guy I used to listen to when I was in school. And fantastic.
Not bad for 67, though, hey?
She was always a very pretty lady. He had always caught her eye. And they were married in a mining valley, sworn to be together till the day that they died. 20 years later, the coal's all gone. There's a golden lamp in his hand. He stands at the bar with his pint and his mates. They all agree together, they don't understand. Meanwhile, little Davy takes his books off to school to learn about the times gone past. When it comes to questions, oh, he puts up his hand. It's one thing that he's just gotta ask. He said, please, sir, won't you give me an answer? Please, sir, you know it doesn't seem fair. Last night as I came in the doorway, I thought I saw my daddy there crying in his chair. She stood there with her arms around him. She promised him a better day. But after 20 years of working underground, it isn't just your living that they take away. Sometimes he'd walk to the edge of his world, gaze at the valley below. He'd think about leaving, or maybe running away. He knew there was nowhere he could go. Please, sir, will you give me an answer? Please, sir, you know I just can't see it. Please, sir, when you make these decisions, do you have a vision of what happens to me? Please, sir, give me an answer. Please, sir, I just can't see. Please, sir, when you make your decisions, do you have a vision of what happens to me? Life goes on in the mining valleys. The young men leave for a better way. And after leaves, he never is there. He knows that love's the only reason he stays. Yeah, love's the only reason he stays. Mean Davy takes his books out to school to learn about the times gone past. When it comes to questions, up goes that hand. There's one thing he's still got to ask. As David says, please, sir, can you give me an answer? Please, sir, you know it doesn't seem fair. Last night as I came in the doorway, I thought I saw my daddy there crying in his chair. Please, sir, won't you give me an answer? Please, sir, I just can't see. Please, sir, when you take your decisions, do you have a vision of what happened to me? Do you have a vision of what happens to me? Do you have a vision of happens to the likes of me?
Tom, a little bit more passion next time would be really good. Beautiful. One of the amazing things is when we were asked if we would do this show, we began to sort of look back, and I listened to the live album. We brought out a studio album, which was okay, but we toured this and we recorded a few shows, and we put a live album out, which we've just released again, as it happens, and it's available here, and you can't get it anywhere else. And But as I listened back to those songs, I was amazed that in some ways these songs could have been written in 2017, which is, you know, the sign of a good tune. It seems to me that the enemy of us all right now is not what's going on out there, because that's blatantly obvious, and we claim that and we name it within songs. But we dearly need songs that remind us of who we are. lest we become cynical, fearful, and put up walls and barriers. The object, I think, of folk music or any good art is to remind us that we're not alone and that we're actually the majority and on the winning side and that we follow light. When I first I listened back to this song of Steve's for the first time in many years, and I have to admit it really struck me, and I was driving along in the car. I had to pull over because there were some tears flowing. It's a beautiful, beautiful song that does exactly what I just said. This is Steve Knightley's The Flood.
After weeks of hard rain, streams that were dry since the war are now flowing again. But the water's still rising, it's only a meter below. On the streets of the old county town, it's got nowhere to go. The river runs out of the hill, and the cellar is starting to fail. The fields and the farmland lie under that blanket of mud, soaking the roots and the branches and rotting the bud. Down here everyone's counting the cost of the flood. Cost of the flood. Under the cruel sun, the desert drifts ever more south. Like the spars of old ships, the cannonballs bleach in the drought. And when they're weary of praying for rain, all the young men are headed for Spain. And now someone lies drowned on the beach where the lovers stretch out down in the town. Round here everyone's watching the world spinning round. See the world spinning round. Let's stand on the white cliffs and look over to France, where hundreds are waiting for darkness to take one more chance. As the trucks in the neon lit parks become cages instead of an ark. Oh,
investment's no good when they're paying their debts with their families, our loans back with blood. Now the dam has been breached, it's the year of the flood. It's the year of the flood.
William Blake said, what's the price of experience? Do men buy it for a song or wisdom for a dance in the street? Though it's bought with the price of all a man has, his house, his wife, his children. Wisdom is sold in the desolate marketplace where none come to buy, and in the withered field where the farmer ploughs for bread in vain. It's an easy thing to triumph in the summer sun and in the vintage, and to sing on the wagon loaded with corn when the red blood is full of wine and the marrow of lamb. It's an easy thing to laugh at wrathful elements, to hear the dog howl at the hungry door and the ox in the slaughterhouse moan. Then the dollar and the groan are quite forgotten, and the poor in prison and the captive in chains, and the slave grinding at the mill and the soldier in the field where the shattered bone is laid in groaning among the happier dead. It's an easy thing to triumph in the tents of prosperity. Thus would I sing and thus rejoice. It's not so for me.
Not so for me.
But it's not so for me.
Not so for me. Not so for me.
It's not so for me.
Not so for me.
Not so. So I've not had the hit.
Did you have one about a fish, didn't you?
But
what was it they described you as, Steve? The gravel-voiced champion of the rural poor.
The gravel-voiced spokesman of the rural poor. And this was the song that got me on Farming Today. Which is success of a sort. And I got given a really hard time by the interviewer. I thought it'd be really easy at 5:30 in the morning. And he said, you've written a song called Country Life. It's just an unbalanced rant. I said, no, it's about a guy who can't afford to live in his own village. He said, but where's the balance? It's an anti-town, an anti-urban rant. I said, these aren't my opinions. They're the opinions of the guy in the song. And he said, but you wrote it. And I said, you don't go up to the actor playing Hamlet and say, be nicer to your mother, do you? You know? Folk music, you know. In folk songs, we can all go out wenching and wailing and hunting, if you want.
Some of us.
But wailing. Who knows? So this is for all you people that work on the land. For all you country boys. Can't afford to live in your own village. Country life. Working in the rain, cutting up wood, didn't do my little brother much good. Lost two fingers in a chainsaw bite, all he does now is drink and fight. Sells a bit of grass on some cars, talks to travel, never gets far. Loves his kids, left his wife, an everyday story of country life. cottage where I was born is the empty shell of a holiday home. Most of the year there's no one there. The village is dead and they don't care. Now we live on the edge of town. Haven't been back since the pub closed down. One man's family pays the price for another man's vision of country life. Let's sing it. Oh, thank you, Shrewsbury. Oh, while my old man is 84, his generation won the war, but he left the farm forever when they only kept on 1 in 10. Landed gentry, county snobs, where were you when they lost their jobs? No one marched or subsidized to save a country way of life. Silent fields, empty lanes, drifting smoke and distant flames. Picture postcard hills on fire, cattle burning funeral pyres. Out to graze, they look so sweet. We hate the blood, but we want the meat. So buy me a beer, I'll take my knife, cut you a slice of country life. Country life. If you want cheap food, then here's the deal. Family farms are brought to heel by a hammer blow of size and scale. Was foot and mouth just another nail in the coffin of this English Welsh dream? Out there on the village green, where angry barons, cap in hand, strip the green and the pleasant land of meadow, woodland, hedgerow, pond. What remains they build upon? No trains, no shops, no pubs. What went wrong in the countryside? Where's the red line gone? Where's the star and the eight bells? And the royal oak and the garage is gone. Same story in country life. That's why I'm singing. Help me out now. Whoa. And all the way to the back, huh? That's a good sound, a bit louder. Oh. Oh. Shrewsbury, on your own, listen, come on. Thank you. Thank you very much.
The very young and the very beautiful can be so aloof, hanging out with the boys, all swaggering boys. I don't even care what other people are there. I just stare and stare and stare. See your shadow in the swimming pool. I see your face in the shaving mirror, time and time and time again.
I'll follow your footsteps so quietly up the back stairs, and I hope and I pray that you're never gonna find me there. Smooth skin and tenderness, long ago on a dark night. Wish I could see you once again to remember that it was true. I wanna be still beside you, quiet and still beside you, listening to your breathing and feeling your warmth again. Whoa. I could stand another 10 years of this fighting, always stabbing and wounding, only getting my own back. I don't wanna battle you to your feet and knees and elbows when I'm eating by the candle at the foot of my own bed. Corresponding disasters every night on the TV, sickening reality. And they laugh about Armageddon, but like a nightmare, it's still waiting there at the end of each and every day. One of the main reasons we got back together, one of the man who had the vision, we've been talking about it for years, but the person who made it happen was Alan Surtees. Alan, the former director and founder of this festival, just sort of his enthusiasm and his vision made us get back together, do a couple of shows and be here today. So we need to thank him very much. I've no confidence in the afterlife, but I got faith in you. Maybe the lightning will strike twice, but I got faith in you. And the man who gets my car to go, I got faith in you. Those who plant the seed, Mr. Jones, I got faith in you.
On stage, there's all together four in our happy band. Mark back there tuning and sorting out the guitars and transporting Mr. Robinson around the country. Josh is on the monitor desk up here, he's from Wimpole. Marcus is on the lights, he's from Topsham. And Rob waits on the sound desk, he's from Buckfastleigh. Give them all a round of applause. And I've got faith in Mr. Tom Robinson.
And I've got faith in Mr. Steve Knightley.
And I've got faith in Mr. Martyn. The spirit of Alan Surtees will always be in this site as long as this festival happens. So much. See your hands, please. Come on, clap us on. We'll be at the signing tent in about 45 minutes. Let's hear it for the crew that have been here all weekend as well. Graham, Stuart, Lawrence. Thank you, guys. The bars will be open long into the night.
talking about our freedom. Freedom to choose what to do with your body. Freedom to believe what you like. Freedom for brothers to love one another. Freedom for black and white. Freedom from harassment, intimidation. Freedom for the mother and wife. Freedom from big brother's interrogation. Freedom to live your own life. Talking about power in the darkness. Frightening lies from the other side. Power in the darkness. Stand up and fight for your institutions fundamental to the British way of life are under attack. Our schools and universities, public transport, public libraries, access to justice, social housing, even our magnificent health service is no longer safe from those who would undermine everything decent and humane in our society. And it's about time we said, enough is enough. And so a return to the traditional British values of tolerance, fair play, standing up for the weak, for the oppressed, for the helpless. And universal, undividable human freedom. Not the freedom to avoid paying the same taxes as the rest of us. Not the freedom for multinationals to avoid paying any taxes whatsoever. Not the freedom for hate-mongering newspaper owners to peddle downright lies about desperate people fleeing for their very lives. And when our glorious leaders have the gall to call themselves the champions of freedom, what they mean is freedom from the unemployed, freedom from the destitute, freedom to treat people like scum, freedom from honesty, freedom from integrity, freedom to look after number one, freedom from the Europeans, freedom from immigrants, freedom from alternative views. They want freedom from the needs of ordinary people. Freedom from the likes of you and me. Power in the darkness. Frightening lies from the other side. Power in the darkness. Stand up and fight for your rights. One more time. Power in the darkness. Frightening lies from the other side. Darkness, stand up and fight for your